Hi everyone, welcome to victoriapiking.com, and today we're going to make this wonderful panna cotta. This is one of my all-time favorite desserts. It's made pretty easy, and I'm giving you the easiest recipe I could find with two toppings. So I hope you enjoy the idea and stay tuned. And by the way, this is perfect stressless dessert for Valentine's Day. You make it in advance, day before, or even 2 days before, and it's cold, it's there, it's easy to serve, and it's just amazing. I have here cold water. Now, to the cold water I'm adding gelatin. This is organic gelatin, non-GMO, very healthy stuff. I just found it, but if you don't have it, you can use powdered one. Powdered one you use a little bit different. Now, this is six sheets. They are going to set 2 cups of hot liquid. So I'm going to add them to just cold water. And they have to be here for about 5 minutes or so to soak. Now, if you are using powdered gelatin, take a cup of milk, or a half and half for this sake, and cover it with the cold milk before you dissolve it inside the hot liquid. So now I'm setting it aside. Take heavy bottom pot, saucepan, and add 2 cups of half and half. Half and half, this is light cream. This is 10% of fat. And it's really easy to find. Usually it's called coffee cream. So 2 cups of this one. At least a tablespoon of vanilla extract goes in. This is good quality vanilla extract. You can use vanilla bean for this recipe, but vanilla extract works perfectly as well here, like so. Half cup of sugar. I'm using this organic evaporated canned juice sugar. You can use any sugar, but you have to know that regular sugar is GMO. This is GMO free and it's organic, so it's relatively good quality sugar. As I told, half cup of this. Now bring it to a boil, but not to the rolling boil, just when the first bubble started to form, take it out of the heat. It's almost boiled, so I'm going to take those ones, this one. You see, I just took squeezed all the water from it, like so, and then I'm adding it here to warm liquid. And mix it in. After the gelatin is dissolved, I'm going to strain it. Because, you know, sometimes you have some kind of lumps from the milk or from the gelatin. So strain it. Oh, it's all foggy. Sorry. At this point, take vessels. Any vessels you like, because it's gelatin, it will take the form of any vessel. This one is pretty. So just feel until you're comfortable with the size. You know, how much you want to be in each vessel. And it depends on how many people you like. I have those ones, which I'm going to take out. So I do want to fill those. Is a classical presentation. Like so. I have this one. This is like wine cup without the leg, and it's pretty cool. I think it will be pretty inside. And do so on until all of the liquids are gone. Just one moment. If you want to leave them as it is, it, you don't want to take them out like here, clean all of those before you're going to put it inside the refrigerator. Otherwise, it will be not so pretty. Pop them to refrigerator for about 4 hours to set, not less. Okay, today I have hard time to decide which topping I want for my panna cotta. I have frozen blueberries and I have frozen raspberries. So I've decided to make two toppings. Take two small saucepan, or as you see here, I have Turkish kettle, or I don't know how it's called. So take two, or you can do only one, you know, you can add anything, any topping you like, any fruit, fresh or otherwise. It's just the way that I like it. So about half cup of berries to each. This is the raspberries goes in. And this is the blueberries go to the other one. Are those beauties? Splash of vanilla to each, about a teaspoon or so, and tablespoon of sugar to each. I love the tartness of the topping with the sweetness of panna cotta, and I think it's just make it perfect. That's it. Another naughty thing that I love, it's rum. I love Jamaican rum, dark rum. So 1 to 2 tablespoons for each. I'm going for 2. By the way, if your child is eating, it's not a problem as well, because most of the alcohol will evaporate anyways. Now, bring it to gentle simmer. Take half a teaspoon of tapioca starch or cornstarch. If you're using cornstarch, please use organic one, otherwise it's genetically modified. Add a little bit of water, couple of teaspoons, and mix it all. When it's boiling, the fruit, add about half of it to each bowl. And then mix for about a second, and that's it, it's done. Do the same to the blueberries as well. And that's it, it's done. Transfer them, the toppings, to the small jar, or I don't know, to the small vessel, and cool them completely in the refrigerator. Now it's liquid. When it's going to be, after it's cooled, it will be a little bit more thick. So that's why I wanted to thicken it with the cornstarch or tapioca starch. After a couple of hours, take bowl with boiling water. You have to make sure that it's absolutely set, completely. You see? It's just beautiful. And put it inside. Only thing, make sure that it's not too much water, that the water won't go inside the our panna cotta. Place it inside hot water for about 10-30 seconds. Now our toppings. So I'm taking the raspberry one and just placing it here. And now take the blueberry one and place the other half. I think it done. So now I'm going to attempt to put panna cotta on top. 1, 2, 3, opa! Ah, it's wonderful. It's just wonderful. Like so. Funny. Let's try our creation. It's just wonderful. Open your mouth. No, unfortunately, I can't give you. But I can try by myself. And it's pretty perfect. So I hope you enjoyed the idea. And don't forget to subscribe, write me a comment, thumbs up me, and cheers, Victoria. See you next time. Love you all. Bye! Yes, and this was my first attempt. As you see, it's a little bit more messy than the other one because I forgot the panna cotta a little bit too long in the hot water.